Getting started with Raspberry Pi. In this video, I'm going to be showing you the various LCD monitors available and some of their capabilities. There are 7 versions of this LCD monitor currently available. The differences between the models are detailed in this table. All of these are touchscreen displays that work with the Raspbian OS. The quality of the image displayed increases with each model of the monitor, but even the smallest one has a good display. Depending on what you intend to use the screen for, different models might be preferable. I'm going to show you 3 models. The smallest is the 3.2-inch Type B. There are also 3.5 and 4-inch available. This is the 5-inch display. All the models of this size and smaller can be used with a finger or an ordinary stylus, because they use a resistive touchscreen. The 7-inch models use a capacitive touchscreen, which I'll talk more about later. The different models also have different ways of connecting to the Pi, which you should consider depending on what projects you want to use the screen for. The models use HDMI and USB, or GPIO pins and HDMI, or just GPIO. The 7-inch model also has a switch on the back of the screen to turn off the backlight. The 7-inch screen is the largest and has the best picture and touch capabilities. The 7-inch BC and 5-inch B types connect to the Pi using 2 cables, HDMI and micro USB to USB touchscreen connections. The C type also has a backlight switch, so you can turn off the screen without turning off the Pi. The 5-inch screen uses a small HDMI connector and GPIO pins. As you can see, it sits directly on top of the Raspberry Pi board and creates basically one connected device, while still offering a fairly large screen that's easy to use. The 3.2, 3.5, and 4-inch screens all use just the GPIO connections and sit on top of the Pi in the same way as the 5-inch screen. To use this device with a Raspberry Pi, you need to download the Raspbian image file for whichever LCD you are using. The different models require different drivers in order to work properly. If you want to keep using the OS image that you've used for other projects, it is possible to separately install the correct drivers, but the provided image will have all the optimal configurations. Once the microSD card is set up properly for use with the screen, the Raspberry Pi will automatically boot so that the Raspbian desktop GUI is usable. This touchscreen could actually replace a large monitor, and you won't need a mouse or keyboard to use your Pi. You can even emulate the action of hovering over something with your cursor, like so. The only additional equipment you'll need is a power source, like an AC converter or batteries, since your computer USB connection probably doesn't provide enough power to support the Pi and the screen and any additional devices you might be using. For the initial setup, you're going to want access to a terminal and keyboard. At that time, you can download additional software to use a virtual keyboard on the device, like this. You can bring up this virtual keyboard through a terminal command if you're using the Pi externally, or you can bring it up from the GUI directly, like I just did. Once it's installed, you can do everything right on the touchscreen, including any terminal commands you may need to do. It's a bit slower than a real keyboard, but it lets you use your Pi with minimal additional hardware as a standalone device, which can be very important in prototyping and convenient for new learners if you don't have a bunch of USB keyboards and mice lying around. With the smaller touchscreens, you can use an ordinary plastic stylus for more precise touch if your finger is too much trouble. The 7-inch monitors have a capacitive touchscreen, which means the screen is more sensitive to your finger's touch. However, since a capacitive screen isn't controlled with pressure, a plastic stylus won't work. If you like, you can get a special capacitive stylus, like you would use with an iPad, Surface, or other common modern touchscreen. There are also many do-it-yourself solutions available. But as you can see, the 7-inch monitor is sensitive enough that it can be fairly easily used without any extra stuff. If you're taking your Raspberry Pi creations on the go, it can be cumbersome to use a monitor, USB keyboard, and USB mouse. So, by using one of these LCD monitors, you can have all of those capabilities together in a small and convenient size. Combined with a Raspberry Pi, these monitors become essentially your own mini touchscreen computer. I hope you enjoy your new LCD touchscreen. Thanks for watching!